किरचॉफ लॉ इज फॉर सर्किट सॉल्विंग। फर्स्ट लॉ था जंक्शन लॉ, किसी भी जंक्शन पे जितना चार्ज आता है उतना चार्ज वहां से बाहर भी निकल जाएगा, दैट इज द फर्स्ट लॉ। फर्स्ट लॉ इज बेस्ड ऑन द कंजर्वेशन ऑफ चार्ज प्रिंसिपल। The total charge incoming a junction will be equal to total charge leaving the junction. Bharat,
Yeah.
okay, did you revise your notes? We derived the formula for the potential of this junction. What was that formula? Potential at this junction. जंक्शन लॉ ये था, जितना चार्ज आएगा उतना ही चार्ज जंक्शन से बाहर भी निकल जाएगा। सो Q1 इज इक्वल टू Q2 प्लस Q3। बाय यूजिंग दिस वी कैलकुलेटेड द पोटेंशियल ऑफ द जंक्शन। इफ द एंड टर्मिनल पोटेंशियल इज V1 V2 एंड V3, वी डिराइव्ड दिस आई गेस। यस, एज फार एज आई रिमेंबर, C1 V1 प्लस C2 V2 प्लस C3 V3 डिवाइडेड बाय C1 प्लस C2 प्लस C3। Right.
Yes, sir. So this is the same as the sum of the charge divided by the total capacitance, right?
Abida,
so this
is again.
This will be
not
the
great.
same as the sum of all the charges divided by the total capacitance.
No. This is not charged by C1 V1. This no, not only V1 battery. This capacitor will have charged C1 V1 only when. Only V1 battery would have connected across. The potential difference across this is not V1. So if you say that total charge divided by, that is technically incorrect. V1 is not the potential difference across C1.
Okay.
Now understood, na?
Yes, sir. Right.
Second law is also called as loop law. In the second law, the total potential drop across any closed loop is always zero. In a closed loop, if we sum the potential drop of each and every element, I think we wrote the statement of second law also. Second law is also called as loop law or voltage law. According to second law, in any closed loop, the net potential drop across closed loop is always zero. The total potential drop across a closed loop is always zero. For very obvious reason, because if it is a closed loop, the initial point and final point is same, both at the same point, so net potential drop is zero, and therefore potential work done is zero and potential drop will be zero. But jab bhi hum kisi loop ke liye potential drop likhenge, we have to use a proper sign convention for the potential. What is the sign convention used for the potential sign? So there are two different sign convention. One is given NCERT, another is given in H.C. Verma. They are exactly opposite. As per the NCERT sign convention, or the one that we will be using, agar hum kisi circuit mein battery ko cross kare, like we have to go either clockwise, start from one point and come back to the same point after completing the loop. If you come back to the same point, the potential drop is becoming zero in the direction. If you are going from positive to negative terminal of a battery, we will take that potential drop.
Vaibhav sir, I have a question.
Yes, bolo beta.
Sir, which one of the two sign conventions is correct, NCERT or H.C. Verma?
Both are correct. You will get exactly the same result. the difference is of minus sign. If you multiply the whole equation by minus sign, the one convention changes to other. Because when we are putting it equal to zero, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. If you multiply the whole equation by minus sign, it will still be the same result. I will take an example and I will make equation by using both of them so that we can understand. If in any cell, in any equation, it is zero on the right hand side, if you multiply both sides by minus one, I get a good. Equation will still remain same. So when we are crossing a circuit in such a way that we cross battery from positive terminal to negative terminal, then the battery EMF will be taken with positive sign. If we are crossing a battery from negative terminal to positive terminal, then we take with negative sign. This EMF, where while completing the loop, suppose we are going anti-clockwise, then the battery we cross from negative terminal to positive terminal. Similarly, when we are going in the capacitor, crossing the capacitor from positive plate to negative plate, or in the direction of the charge, potential difference across capacitor formula is Q by C, then it will be taken plus Q by C. If we are going in a capacitor from opposite to the direction of charge, or from negative plate to the positive plate, then it will be minus Q by C. This is the sign convention that NCERT follows and we will be following. NCERT has this particular chapter, no? But in the current circuit in the NCERT, these equations are used. Okay, so Kirchhoff law will be a must if there are two batteries. Single battery, still we can apply the series, parallel or something like that. But if there are more than one battery in any circuit, it is not possible with the help of any other type of series or parallel combinations. Suppose this is a circuit. In this circuit, there are three loops, two smaller one, independent one, and one is the bigger one. Suppose this is battery has a potential V1, another battery has a potential V2. These capacitors are C1, C2, C3, and C4. In the circuit, we have to find charge on each capacitor. We have to find the potential across C3, suppose we have to find energy in C4, something like that. All these informations we can solve, get with the help of solving Kirchhoff law equation. Right, so if two batteries are or more batteries are, then we have the best method of Kirchhoff law to solve that circuit. And circuit solve karne ke liye hame sabse first step kya karna hai? We have to assume a current distribution, charge distribution in this case. Assume a charge distribution with the help of following junction law. So if we suppose assume first battery gives charge Q1 and the second battery gives charge Q2 into the circuit. So iske raste mein aayega capacitor Q1, C1, ispe charge ho gaya Q1. That capacitor will be charged with Q1. Another battery provides charge Q2. Iske raste mein C4 and then C3 will also get same amount of charge. And then Q2. Right, Q1 plus Q2 will be added. So the total charge that goes out is Q1 plus Q2. Q1 goes back to the first battery, Q2 goes back to the second bat. You understood the charge distribution, how we did that? Bharat? Arnav?
Yes.
Can you make this
again? That is only the safer side is from the positive terminal, we consider a charge is given. Q1 is delivered from the battery V1, Q2 is delivered from the battery V2, and at this junction, both Q1 and Q2 will be added. Total charge that goes in the junction must be equal to the charge leaving the junction. So that becomes Q1 plus Q2. Good. Right? So we have now this two different independent loops. We will consider these two loops separately. And now this loop, we have to assume we have to write the charge. We have to write the Kirchhoff's voltage law. Suppose this is loop one. And this is loop two. Equation for loop one. हम कहीं से भी स्टार्ट कर सकते हैं. सपोज वी स्टार्ट फ्रॉम दिस पॉइंट ए एंड एरो इज आल्सो यू कैन गो एंटी क्लॉकवाइज, यू कैन गो क्लॉकवाइज एज पर योर चॉइस. सपोज वी स्टार्ट फ्रॉम पॉइंट ए, वी स्टार्ट फ्रॉम पॉइंट ए, व्हेन वी क्रॉस दिस फर्स्ट बैटरी इन एंटी क्लॉकवाइज डायरेक्शन, वी आर गोइंग फ्रॉम नेगेटिव टू पॉजिटिव, सो दैट पोटेंशियल विल बी टेकन विद अ माइनस साइन, माइनस वी टू, राइट. Then in the direction of charge, so across this C4 capacitor, potential will be taken positive. Again in C3 capacitor, we are going in the direction of charge plus Q2 by C3. फिर हम इधर आ जाते हैं इस वाले capacitor में. That C2 capacitor, it has the total charge of Q1 plus Q2 divided by C2. Again we come back to point A, so that will be equal to zero. Start from point A. Cover the whole loop, all the circuit elements which comes in between, their potential has to be used with the proper sign convention. So like we cross this V2 volt battery from negative to positive, that's why it is taken with minus sign. Then the second capacitor C4, we are going in the direction of the flow of charge, that's why we took it positive, plus Q2 by C4. Then the third capacitor C3, again, we are in the direction of charge. So again, we took it positive. In the capacitor C2, again, it will be positive. Right? Ab wapas A pe pahunch gaya, so total potential drop will be zero. It will be equal to zero. Today, loop one ki equation aage samajh mein kaise bani hai?
Yes, sir.
Equation for loop one?
Yes, sir.
Bharat, Arnav, Rahul.
Yes, sir.
Yes, it's clear.
Okay. Rahul, then how will be the equation for loop 2? Write the equation for loop 2 and now suppose now we are going in clockwise direction. Now we are completing this loop in clockwise direction starting from same point A. Rahul. Kanan, can you give this equation? Loop 2 ke liye starting from point A. Hum battery cross kar rahe hain, idhar minus se plus, so it will be positive, negative. Again negative because we are going from negative to positive. In the direction of charge, Q1 by C1 again. In the direction of charge, again Q1 plus Q2 by C2. We came back to the same point, so that will be zero. Total, there are two variables, Q1 and Q2. And to solve them, there are two equations. Two variable, two equation, we can solve and we can find the value of Q1 and Q2. And therefore, we now know the charge on each capacitor. गलती से अगर सपोज हमने जो चार्ज अज्यूम किए थे वो अगर अपोजिट डायरेक्शन में होंगे देन इट विल कम आउट टू बी नेगेटिव. सो इफ चार्ज कम्स आउट नेगेटिव मींस द डायरेक्शन ऑफ चार्ज दैट वी अज्यूम्ड एग्जैक्टली अपोजिट टू दैट इज द एक्चुअल चार्ज. राइट, अंडरस्टूड?
यस सर.
ओके, एक इक्वेशन एक क्वेश्चन सॉल्व करके देख लेते हैं, छोटा सा सिंपल सा.
फाइंड सर, कैन यू गो बैक टू द प्रीवियस?
Yes, yes, yes. I am explaining more. It's written only equation directly. So you have to convince yourself that it is written using the correct sign convention. In the direction of negative to positive, it is negative. So when we cross a battery from negative to positive, it is negative. When we are going in the direction of charge across the capacitor, it is plus Q by C. Opposite to the charge, it is minus Q by C. Negative terminal of battery to positive terminal of battery, it will be negative. Positive terminal to negative terminal, it will be positive. Correct? Okay. Now there are two variables, Q1, Q2, two equation for two independent loops. We can solve and we can find these values of Q1 and Q2. Once we have the equation, we can find the charge. And if we have charge, we know each and every charge capacitor energy, each and every capacitor potential. That is called the solving of the circuit. Find the charge on each capacitor in the circuit shown. थोड़ा सा बैटरी का बस मैंने सिंबल अपोजिट कर दिया बैटरी के डायरेक्शन. दिस इज 10 वोल्ट, हियर इट इज सपोज 20 वोल्ट, 2 माइक्रोफेरेड, 1 माइक्रोफेरेड एंड 5 माइक्रोफेरेड. So there are these three capacitor and two batteries. So we have to find with the help of Kirchhoff law. First step is use the charge distribution. Use the charge distribution. So suppose the first battery, one battery provides charge Q1. Let's say this provides charge Q1. Or abhi Q1 mein se idhar aage the second battery provides charge Q2. So at this junction, if we apply the junction law, this becomes how much? Q1 minus Q2. Q1 charge yahan pe aaya tha, Q2 aage chala gaya. So the remaining charge will be going to the second junction. So in this capacitor of 1 microfarad charges Q2. Aur Q2 mein se aage idhar gaya Q1. Kyunki idhar se Q1 minus Q2 aake isme add ho gaya. By using junction law, Q1 minus Q2 is coming, Q2 is coming. Dono milke, it becomes Q1 again. So that Q1 charges on this 2 microfarad capacitor. This is the charge distribution. Assume charge distribution. We have two different loops. We will write equation for these two loops and then we will solve these equations. चार्ज डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन में बस आपको जंक्शन लॉ ध्यान रखना है, आप चार्ज कहीं से भी ले सकते हो, पॉजिटिव टर्मिनल से, नेगेटिव टर्मिनल से, यू कैन टेक फ्रॉम एनी डायरेक्शन चार्ज, Q1, Q2 या फिर Q1 बैटरी. सो चार्ज वी कैन ओनली द जंक्शन लॉ शुड नॉट फेल एट एनी जंक्शन, द टोटल चार्ज हैज टू बी जीरो. लूप वन की इक्वेशन सपोज अगेन वी स्टार्ट फ्रॉम पॉइंट ए, हमने बैटरी क्रॉस की नेगेटिव से पॉजिटिव की तरफ, सो इट विल बी -10. Then in the direction of the flow of charge, it will be positive Q2/1. Again, opposite to the direction of charge. अभी हम इसमें opposite जा रहे हैं charge के. So that will be taken the opposite sign, minus sign, Q1 minus Q2/5. And that is equal to zero. Equation for loop number one.
Start from taken a minus sign.
Yeah, because the charge here is going up. And yes, we are crossing downwards, opposite to it.
Okay.
Opposite to the charge flow, it is negative. In the direction of flow of charge, it is positive.
Right.
So, multiply with 5, it will become minus 50 plus 5Q2 minus Q1 plus Q2 is equal to 0. So, first equation comes minus Q1 plus 6Q2. Is equal to 50. This is equation for loop 1. Similarly, write for equation for loop 2. And again, we are going in clockwise direction, starting from any point, let's say point A. So now in this second loop, we are in the direction of the flow of charge. In this also, charge is going up. We are also going in that direction. So it will be plus Q1 minus Q2/5. Again, the direction of flow of charge plus Q1/2 minus 20 is equal to 0. Got it? Equation for loop 2 understood?
Yes.
Right, now multiply this by 10, I guess. 2Q1 minus Q2 plus 5Q1 minus 200 is equal to 0. 7Q1 minus 2Q2 is equal to 200. These are the two equations. Solve equation 1 and 2 for the value of Q1 and Q2. This you have to tell me. Two linear equation and two variable, solve for Q1 and Q2. Yes. पहले तो इक्वेशन अगर बन गई सही तो सॉल्व हो जाएगा. इक्वेशन के लिए ओनली थिंग इज साइन कन्वेंशन. नाउ भरत, सपोज इफ यू यूज एचसी वर्मा साइन कन्वेंशन, देन द फर्स्ट इक्वेशन वुड हैव बीकन 10 माइनस Q2 प्लस Q1 माइनस Q2. सो एग्जैक्टली द सेम इक्वेशन मल्टीप्लाइड बाय अ नेगेटिव साइन. दैट विल बी द इक्वेशन फॉर लूप यूजिंग द अदर साइन कन्वेंशन, द एचसी वर्मा साइन. Yes. Solve these two equations, find the value. So how much is 7 se multiply karenge? 7Q1 gone. 42 minus 2, that's 40. And it become 350 minus 200. How much? 150/40. Q2 is 150/40. Please confirm the answer. Q2 is how much? मेरे हिसाब से तो ये 150/40 आ रहा है शायद, which is 15/4 microcoulomb. Is it correct? Yes, is it correct? And this is coming out to be 650/20. Fifteen by four microcoulomb. Q Q1 is 65 by 2 microcoulomb. Find the value of Q1 and Q2. Is it correct? Are you getting the same answer?
Sir, I'm still so.
Yes, Bharat.
Sir, I said that I'm still solving.
Okay. No, we are getting same answer. Pranay, confirm.
No, sir, I got a different answer. I'm checking.
I'm getting different answer. Okay, then. Pranay?
Sir, Q2 same aa raha hai, Q1 nikal raha hai.
Kitna aa raha
hai? Q1 same aa raha hai, Q2 nikal raha hai.
Okay. I multiplied equation 1 by 7 and then added to equation 2. Achha, okay. So what is the charge on 5 microfarad capacitor? That will be Q1 minus Q2. Charge on 5 microfarad capacitor. Baki sab pe to directly Q1 Q2 se pata pad gaya. Charge on 5 microfarad capacitor is Q1 minus Q2. Q1 is 65 by 2 minus 55 by 4. Answer is seventy-five by four microcoulomb. अब charge आ गया, energy निकालनी होगी तो Q square by 2C, potential निकालना होगा तो Q by C. Any method, any formula we can use. So we can solve any complicated circuit with the help of Kirchhoff's law.
Sir, I've got the correct answers.
Okay, very nice, very nice. So that's how we apply the Kirchhoff's law in the capacitor circuit, and by using these equations, we can find the charge. Or our first charge again means. Now we know energy, potential, any.
So when I distributed the charge across the circuit, I did it a little differently, but answer same.
Your voice is again not very clear. Come again.
So when I distributed the charge across the circuit, I did it a little differently, but answer is natural.
No,
that's okay.
Answer will be same. You do any kind of distribution, doesn't matter. The answer, ultimately final answer will be exactly same. Kirchhoff law use करके अब हम circuit में equivalent capacitance भी calculate कर सकते हैं. So जो हम special cases कर रहे थे उसी में next 8th या 9th जो भी होगा. Finding equivalent capacitance using Kirchhoff law for a general circuit. Equivalent capacitance using Kirchhoff's law. So one of these circuit Wheatstone bridge, but not a balanced one. If it is not a balanced Wheatstone bridge, then we have to solve with the help of Kirchhoff's law. So hum abhi dusra example le lete hain. Let's take a example of 12 capacitors connected in the sides of a cube. और हमें इसका कैलकुलेट करना है कैपेसिटेंस. अब अगर हम सिर्फ इतना बोले कि इसका कैपेसिटेंस कैलकुलेट करना, दैट इज अ वेग इनकम्प्लीट स्टेटमेंट. वी हैव टू स्पेसिफाई दोज पॉइंट्स आल्सो अक्रॉस व्हिच वी विश टू कैलकुलेट द इक्विवेलेंट कैपेसिटेंस. So these are these 12 capacitors connected on the sides of a quadrilateral, and we need to find the overall equivalent capacitance of this circuit. So suppose we have to find across the body diagonal. ऐसे इसमें बहुत सारे points हो सकते हैं. There are three standard one. The equivalent capacitance of this circuit across the body diagonal. Body diagonal का मतलब एक point इधर नीचे का A और दूसरा point इधर opposite corner का B. इन दोनों के बीच में we have to find the equivalent capacitance. कोई भी दो series parallel में नहीं लगा सकते. Symmetry अगर आपको लग रहा है symmetry तो उसको भी हम clear कर लेते हैं. We can convert this 3D into 2D and then we can better see the is there a plane of symmetry or not. अभी इसमें plane of symmetry दिख रही है A और B के बीच में. Is there a symmetry across AB? Symmetry का मतलब था AB के ठीक बीच से perpendicularly अगर कोई plane रखे, that plane should like act like a mirror. Left side of that plane and right side of that plane, the image, the circuit should be exactly mirror image.
Yes, sir.
3D को हम 2D में चेंज करके देख लेते हैं. कैसे? ऊपर से सर्किट को प्रेस कर दिया फ्लैट, जो ऊपर का स्क्वायर है वो नीचे वाले स्क्वायर के बेस में आ जाएगा. वी आर चेंजिंग दिस 3D सर्किट इनटू 2D सर्किट. ये नीचे वाला बेस वाला स्क्वायर है बड़ा सा, और ये जो ऊपर वाला स्क्वायर है वो इसके बीच में आ गया. And these four vertical ones, this becomes slant. ये बन गया सर्किट का 3D का 2D वर्जन. अब हमें वो पॉइंट ढूंढना है जिसके बीच में हम कैलकुलेट कर रहे थे. एक पॉइंट तो था ये A, and another point is this, the top most corner. Between these two points, is there a symmetry? Obviously not. We can see that across this point AB there is no diagonal symmetry, so we cannot apply that principle of that symmetry. But there is another type of symmetry that we can see here. There is no plane of symmetry is the 3D circuit. So jab bhi hame kisi bhi circuit mein series parallel ko samajh mein aaye, ultimately hamare paas ek hi option basta hai, we connect a battery in that circuit. We connect a battery across those terminal, और फिर Kirchhoff law apply करके हम ये calculate करें that how much charge that battery is going to provide by taking Q and then distributing in the circuit, writing the loop equation. Loop law से हम ये charge calculate कर सकते हैं. Once we have the value of charge, the battery provides charge in the circuit given as Q is equal to C equivalent into V. C equivalent into V, that is the total charge that battery provided. So from that we can also calculate equivalent capacitance. Q, charge provided by the battery or charge given by the battery in any circuit will be always Q is equal to CV. So अगर हम इस पूरे को हटा के एक single capacitor assume कर लें जिसकी value है C equivalent, the equivalent capacitance will become Q upon V. So पहले हम Q calculate करें by using the Kirchhoff law, और फिर Q by V का ratio निकाले. That Q by V value will be equal to the equivalent, will be equal to the equivalent capacitance of that general circuit, which cannot be solved by any other method. Okay, बेटा ये methods समझ आ रहा है? करेंगे कैसे? That we will see. अगर हमने सीरीज पैरेलल कुछ नहीं कर पा रहा है, सो एक ही ऑप्शन बचता है, कनेक्ट अ बैटरी बैटरी से चार्ज लो, चार्ज को डिस्ट्रीब्यूट करो एंड दैट चार्ज शुड बी दैट कैलकुलेट दैट चार्ज यूजिंग द किरचॉफ लॉ एंड देन वी कैन फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ क्यू बाई वी एंड दैट क्यू बाई वी वैल्यू विल बी सी इक्विवेलेंट. अब इस सर्किट में थोड़ी एडवांटेज है, प्लेन ऑफ सिमेट्री तो नहीं है, देयर इज नो प्लेन ऑफ सिमेट्री, सो 3D से 2D में कन्वर्ट करके हमने इसको वेरीफाई भी कर लिया. जब हम बॉडी डायगोनल के क्रॉस कैलकुलेट कर रहे हैं, वी कैन नॉट यूज दी प्लेन ऑफ सिमेट्री, बट देयर इज अनदर टाइप ऑफ सिमेट्री दैट वी कैन यूज एंड दैट इज नेटवर्क सिमेट्री. ए से बी तक पहुंचने के लिए देयर आर टोटल 3 नेटवर्क्स एंड ऑल दोस 3 नेटवर्क्स आर एग्जैक्टली आइडेंटिकल, इधर 1, 2, 3. There are three paths in which that charge is divided. A से B तक आप किसी भी रास्ते से जाओगे, exactly identical path is that. So अगर path exactly identical है तो charge भी equally divided होगा. Q by 3 and Q by 3. Total charge Q given by the battery will be distributed in this three network equally. It become Q by 3, Q by 3 and Q by 3. Right? यहाँ तक कोई doubt? This step is clear. It's not having the plane of symmetry, but there is a network symmetry. A से जो आगे का network है, that network is exactly identical in these three paths. Now this Q by 3 at this junction is again going to divide into two identical type of network. So it will be again equally divided Q by 6 and Q by 6. इधर से जो Q by 3 आया था, that will also get divided into Q by 6, Q by 6. The third one. These gets divided again in Q by 6 and Q by 6. ये Q by 6, इधर से Q by 6, दोनों मिलके फिर से हो गए Q by 3, Q by 6, Q by 6, दोनों मिलके फिर से आ गए Q by 3, Q by 6, Q by 6, join again to become Q by 3, Q by 3, Q by 3, Q by 3, सब मिलके फिर से बन गए Q. That is the symmetrical charge distribution because this circuit has network symmetry. Circuit has network symmetry, each branch equally divided. There are three branches. Charge entering from A is equally divided into the three branches. Q by 3, Q by 3, Q by 3 at the point of entry A, which again gets equally divided into two similar type of branch. Q by 3 become Q by 6 and Q by 6, which combine again to become Q by 3, Q by 3, Q by 3. So this is the circuit. हमने charge distribution कर लिया है और अब हम कोई भी एक loop ले सकते हैं. We can consider any one loop in which there is a battery as well as capacitor also. So सबसे simple loop जो दिख रहा है, that is the outside one. ये जो सबसे बाहर वाला loop है, we will consider that only. This one battery, इधर का एक capacitor, ये दूसरा capacitor और ये तीसरा, and then again we come back to battery. So this dotted line shows the direction of addition of the algebraic sum of potential. The algebraic sum of potential of each element in a closed loop must be zero. The loop समझ में आ गया ना, कौन सा, ये बाहर बाहर वाले जो three capacitors है और इसके साथ battery. Including these three capacitor and battery, it makes a closed loop. और उस closed loop में हमने Kirchhoff's law apply करना है. Understood this? Charge कैसे divide हुआ? By symmetry. और charge को divide करने के बाद हमने सबसे बाहर वाले loop के लिए we are applying now the Kirchhoff's law. ये बैटरी क्रॉस की माइनस से प्लस, इट बिकम माइनस वी. फिर हम गए बैटरी चार्ज की डायरेक्शन में, कैपेसिटर में क्यू बाई थ्री सी. फिर गए चार्ज की डायरेक्शन में क्यू बाई सिक्स सी. फिर से चार्ज की डायरेक्शन में क्यू बाई थ्री सी. अगेन वी कम बैक टू द बैटरी व्हिच इज इक्वल टू जीरो. हम किरचॉफ लॉ यूज करके किसी भी क्यूब में अगर 12 कैपेसिटर्स हो, वी आर फाइंडिंग द इक्विवेलेंट कैपेसिटेंस ऑफ दैट लूप, दैट सर्किट हैविंग 12 कैपेसिटर्स इन ईच ब्रांच. बॉडी डायगोनल में कनेक्ट करने पे इट बिकम परफेक्टली सिमेट्रिकल. चार्ज गेट्स डिवाइडेड इक्वली इन द थ्री ब्रांचेस व्हिच गेट्स फर्दर डिवाइडेड एज q/6 q/6 एंड व्हिच कंबाइन टुगेदर टू मेक q/3 q/3. अब ये जो हमने एक लूप कंसिडर किया, इन दैट लूप वी कैन नाउ फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ q/v. दिस इक्वेशन इज क्लियर? Okay, so we take V on the other side. V is equal to q/c common कर लोगे तो 1/3 plus 1/6 plus 1/3 आ जाएगा. And that becomes 5/6. That become 5q/6c. And from there we can find the value of q upon v becomes 60/5. So equivalent capacitance of this 12 capacitor is checked.
So could you show the charge distribution on the 2D circuit?
On
the 2D circuit.
On the 2D circuit?
Yes, sir.
What?
The charge distribution. Jab 3D mein kya uska 2D mein dikha sakte ho?
Yeah, it will be similar.
Because the 3D circuit is a little confusing to look at.
So circuit is little ugly. That's why q/3 q/3 q/3. Again, it gets divided as q/6 q/6. This q/3 will become q/6 q/6. This q/3 will become q/6 and q/6. q/6 q/6 makes q/3 here. q/6 q/6 makes q/3 here. This q/6 and this q/6 makes q/3 here. Battery is connected between these two terminals. Since it is the diagonal point, and that's why it is not having any plane of symmetry. This is also an NCRT. This is also an NCRT. School level only. Resistor में भी ऐसे हम 12 resistor लगा के cube बनाएंगे. Yes, note करो. Understood?
It's too nice.
Yeah. So equivalent capacitance using Kirchhoff's law. Body diagonal में तो आ गया इस तरह से, लेकिन अगर हमें और किसी point के across निकलना हो, suppose we have to find.
Could you go back to that page for a second? No, that's it.
Okay. So next is across the phase diagonal. This was across the body diagonal. Now we have to find the equivalent across phase diagonal. Okay, so let's draw another circuit. Method will change now because for a phase diagonal, it is not having a network symmetry. Phase diagonal का मतलब एक इधर पॉइंट ए और एक इधर बी. राहुल मेहर बेटा राहुल अभी हमें कैलकुलेट करना है अक्रॉस दिस फेज डायगनल. इसमें बैटरी अगर लगाएंगे भी तो देयर इज नॉट अ सिमेट्री, नॉट अ परफेक्टली सिमेट्रिकल सर्किट. सो इसके लिए 3D से 2D कन्वर्ट करना हेल्पफुल होगा बिकॉज इन दिस केस देयर इज अ प्लेन ऑफ सिमेट्री. ये नीचे वाला बेस है this point is A and this is B. Now you can see if we consider the plane passing perpendicularly through the midpoint across AB. If we consider this perpendicularly passing through the midpoint, then it has a vertical plane of symmetry. On this vertical plane of symmetry, there are two capacitors lying on it. Got it? In this case, when we convert 3D to 2D, we can see that this circuit has a plane of symmetry. Plane of symmetry should pass through the midpoint perpendicularly, and therefore these two capacitors can be removed. In dono capacitor ko circuit se hata denge, and then it will become a normal usual series parallel circuit. Okay. What is the answer in this case? Across this phase diagonal, there is a vertical plane of symmetry. And in that vertical plane of symmetry, two capacitor lies, so we can remove that. If you remove these two capacitors, then circuit will become simple to solve. What will be equivalent capacitance then? Yes. What is the equivalent capacitance now between A and B?
40 mF.
Remove this and remove this. ये C और C सीरीज में आ जाएंगे C by 2, नीचे C और C सीरीज में आ जाएंगे C by 2, then C by 2 in parallel becomes C. So ऊपर वाले ब्रांच में एक C, मतलब आप दूसरा सर्किट बनाना, not the same one. कितना है आंसर?
4c/3
4c/3 4c by 3. So, ऊपर हो गया c by 2, that becomes c. And so, ऊपर वाले branch में c और c series में आ जाएंगे, that becomes c by 2. C by 2. C by 2 ऊपर से, C by 2 नीचे से, और जो बीच में है ये कितना? C by 3, C by 2, C by 2, C हो गया, so that becomes C, C and C between A and B. This is the circuit. That becomes C by 2, C by 3 and C by 2 in parallel. इसके लिए 2D में convert करना is much better method. So that becomes 4C/3. C equivalent is 4C/3. Face diagonal, body diagonal, and third is across an edge. Across an edge. Edge का मतलब किसी भी एक side के along. When there are 12 capacitors and we want to find the capacitor equivalent capacitors across an edge. बेटा राहुल हो क्लास में ना? Rahul, you are not responding. Okay. Rahul, twelve capacitors. We have to find across an edge. Between these two points A and B. Now we have to calculate the equivalent capacitance of a cube across these two points. अब इसको अगर हम फिर से वापस जाके देखते हैं 2D वाले सर्किट में, so there is a plane of symmetry, but that plane of symmetry cannot be used because ना तो उसपे कोई junction है और ना ही उसपे कोई capacitor है. There is no junction and no capacitor on that plane of symmetry. वो इन चारों कैपेसिटर्स के एग्जैक्टली बीच से पास होगी. दैट इज पासिंग थ्रू द, इफ दिस पॉइंट इज ए एंड दिस पॉइंट इज बी, सो देयर इज अ वर्टिकल प्लेन ऑफ सिमेट्री, बट वर्टिकल दैट वर्टिकल प्लेन ऑफ सिमेट्री इज नॉट नो यूज बिकॉज़ देयर इज नो जंक्शन और देयर इज नो कैपेसिटर लाइंग ऑन दैट प्लेन ऑफ सिमेट्री. तो हम इसको उस मेथड से सॉल्व नहीं कर सकते. इज देयर अ नेटवर्क ऑफ सिमेट्री? नेटवर्क सिमेट्री, इज देयर अ नेटवर्क सिमेट्री एज वेल?
नो.
इज देयर अ नेटवर्क सिमेट्री?
नो सर.
No, yes, obviously not, because one branch is only of one capacitor. Agar hum suppose isko thodi der ke liye bhul jate hain, leave this one. Now is there a network symmetry? Agar hum A aur B ke beech mein koi battery lagaye, forget that one single capacitor. Is there a network symmetry now? There are two branches. Compare them step by step. Are these branches exactly identical? Yes. Yes. These branches are exactly identical. How? इधर जाएंगे पहले एक कैपेसिटर मिला C का and the other side also the same capacitor C. This gets divided into two branches. This gets divided into two branches. So these two network are identical. If we leave the third one, these two are having exactly same network of capacitor. So they will draw the same charge from the circuit, from the battery. So इसमें क्या करेंगे? We can apply that. और भी बहुत सारे मेथड हैं, but this method will make the question easy. यहाँ से network symmetry use कर लेंगे हम. The charge Q that enters, same charge will be going into these two branches, Q1, and the third one has a different charge, Q. Two networks are exactly identical, so they will have exactly same charge. अभी चार्ज सेम है, कैपेसिटर भी सेम है, सो सेम अमाउंट ऑफ पोटेंशियल विल बी ड्रॉप्ड. दैट्स व्हाई दीस टू पॉइंट्स विल हैव सेम पोटेंशियल, सो दे बोथ आर कंसीडर्ड एज वन. दे बोथ आर कंसीडर्ड एज पॉइंट नंबर वन बिकॉज दे आर सेम पोटेंशियल पॉइंट्स आर अज्यूम्ड एज सेम पॉइंट इन द सर्किट, राइट? राइट बेटा, ये लॉजिक समझ में आया? ये लॉजिक समझ में आया ना? दो नेटवर्क, दो ब्रांचेस आइडेंटिकल है, थर्ड वन इज डिफरेंट. सो इन दीज टू ब्रांचेस इट विल हैव द सेम चार्ज एंड द थर्ड वन हैज डिफरेंट, सो Q1 एंड Q2. अब ऐसे हम दूसरी तरफ आ जाते हैं, ऑन द अदर साइड B की तरफ. यहाँ से चार्ज Q2 आया बाय सिमेट्री, द अदर टू ब्रांचेस विल डिलीवर दोस चार्ज Q1 एंड Q1 सिमेट्रिकली. सो जिस पॉइंट से चल के आ रहे हैं वहां पर भी दोनों का पोटेंशियल सेम होगा. दीज टू विल आल्सो बी एट सेम पोटेंशियल. दीज टू पॉइंट्स कैन बी गिवन सेम नंबर, सो जस्ट टेक देम एज दो बच गए पॉइंट. दिस इज 3 एंड दिस इज 4. So in any circuit, now we have to do the numbering first, and after the numbering we redraw that circuit by using the location of each capacitor. A is connected to 1, B is connected to 2, or beech mein 3 and 4. Locate each capacitor one by one. A to 1, how many capacitors are there? Two. A to 1, this 1 and 2. These two capacitors are between A and 1. Right? A to 1, these two capacitors both will be in parallel. One, two, three, how many capacitors? 2. 1, 2, 3, again 2 capacitors. Three to four, again there are 2 capacitors. 2 to 4, these two capacitors. 2 to B, again 2 capacitors. 1 to 2, 1 to 2 and 1 to 2, again two capacitors. देखने में और लग रहा है बट ये सॉल्व हो जाएगा. कितने कैपेसिटर्स हुए टोटल अभी? हाउ मेनी कैपेसिटर्स इन दिस? हाउ मेनी कैपेसिटर्स? 11. और इसमें कितने थे टोटल कैपेसिटर में? 12. एक कौन सा रह गया बिटवीन ए एंड बी? तो अब इसको हम सॉल्व कर सकते हैं. दिस सर्किट इज क्वाइट सिंपलीफाइड विद द हेल्प ऑफ दैट पोटेंशियल थिंग. वी गेव द सेम नंबर. CNC 2C, CNC 2C, 2C 2C, C and C in series. ऐसे ये बन जाएगा 2C, this becomes 2C, this becomes 2C. So, solve करो फटाफट कितना आएगा ये. Now it can be solved step by step. This become 2C, this become 2C, 2C, 2C and C in series. It becomes C by 2 और नीचे का 2C, C by 2 and 2C in parallel. कैलकुलेटर ये बताओ कितना आएगा ए और बी के बीच में. 12 कैपेसिटर्स अक्रॉस द साइड ऑफ अ क्यूब.
ट्वेल्व बाई सेवन
कितना?
12 बाई 7.
12 by 7 ना?
Yes sir.
Oh, it should come out 12 by 7, 12C by 7. Okay, कैसे आएगी 12C by 7? 2C, 2C, C. So बीच वाले सर्किट में हम आ जाएगा ऊपर की तरफ. This is C. This becomes 2C. ये ऊपर का हो गया C by 2 और नीचे का हो गया 2C and 2C. C by 2 and 2C become 5C by 2. This becomes 5C by 7. 5C by 7 and C in parallel become 12C by 7. Okay, so हमने ये Kirchhoff law use करके हमने एक तो देखा circuit that is for across the void diagonal, across the phase diagonal and across the edge. आप देखते हैं कुछ ज्यादा सर्किट जिसमें हम Kirchhoff's law के बिना सॉल्व नहीं कर सकते, जैसे Wheatstone bridge, unbalanced Wheatstone bridge. Wheatstone bridge, but circuit is not valid. If not balanced, then. If any such circuit, Wheatstone bridge is not balanced, then we have only one option. We can use the Kirchhoff's law. So, थोड़ी सी symmetry ले रहते हैं फिर से. Not exactly the Wheatstone bridge balance, but circuit को थोड़ा simplify करने के लिए we can use like 2 microfarad, 3 microfarad. On the other side, it is 3 microfarad and 2 microfarad. और बीच वाला है suppose 1 microfarad. you have to find the capacitance between A and B. This looks like a Wheatstone, but it is not a balanced Wheatstone. Again, connect a battery. Connect a battery and connect the battery, draw the charge. Now, this is one symmetry I'm showing, and that is diagonal symmetry. That is the diagonal symmetry. अगर हम कोई बैटरी यहाँ लगा देते हैं, we have to calculate this charge given by the battery, and then the ratio of Q by V will give the C equivalent. So this Q suppose divides into Q1 and Q2 in these two branches. By using the diagonal symmetry, because इस Wheatstone में जो ऊपर की तरफ कैपेसिटर था 2 microfarad, वो दूसरे में नीचे तरफ है diagonally opposite. By using the diagonal symmetry logic, अगर ये Q1 ऊपर 2 microfarad से गया था, then that Q1 will also come through the 2 microfarad capacitor. ये Q2 इधर गया था, this Q2 will also be right. अब Q2 में से Q1 आगे निकल गया, तो बचेगा Q2 minus Q1. Q2 minus Q1 will be along this branch. They both join here to become Q2. और Q1 plus Q2 मिलके फिर से Q. फिर से Q. By using diagonal symmetry, हमने charge distribution कर लिया. अब हमें एक तो ये बाहर loop की equation लिखनी है. Equation for loop one, equation for loop two. For loop one, equation आएगी minus v, और ये बाहर बाहर हम Q2 से जा रहे हैं, तो Q2 by three. फिर Q1 से जा रहे हैं, Q1 में capacitance है two, Q1 by two is equal to zero. This becomes three Q1 plus two Q2 is equal to six v. Write equation for loop 2. Charge ki direction mein ja rahe hain, isliye positive Q1 by 2. Charge ke opposite ja rahe hain, charge upar ki taraf ja raha hai, niche ki taraf ja rahe hain, isliye ye negative aa jayega Q2 minus Q1 by 1. Aur fir se charge ke opposite ja rahe hain, minus Q2 upon 3, that will be equal to 0. In loop number two, start from point A. Charge ki direction mein positive, charge ki flow ki opposite direction mein negative. So it will be how much? Q1 by 2 multiply by 6 and 3 Q1 minus 6 Q2 minus Q1 minus 2 Q2 is equal to 0. 3 or plus 6 again, 9 Q1 is equal to 8 Q2. Q1 is 8 by 9 times Q2. Substitute here. Q1 is 8 by 9 times Q2 plus 2 Q2 is equal to 6. 14 by 3 Q2 is equal to 6. Q2 is equal to 9 by 7. Q2 again 9 by 7 V. There he again V bhi tha. In terms of V, Q2 is 9 V by 7. So Q1 will become 8 V by 7. Q, the total charge given by the battery, Q is equal to Q1 plus Q2. Total charge given by the battery is Q1 plus Q2. This become 9 plus 8, 17 by 7. 17 by 7 V is equal to Q. Q by V again 17 by 7. So equivalent capacitance is 17 by 7 microfarad. equivalent capacitance is 17/7 microfarad. ऐसे क्वेश्चन को करने का और कोई तरीका नहीं है. अगर ये बीच में डायगोनल सिमेट्री नहीं होती तो एक वेरिएबल और आ जाता Q1, Q2, Q3 और फिर हम उन तीनों को मिला के सॉल्व करते. Yes, clear. Understood this example?
Can you explain this again?
Yeah. So it was a diagonal symmetry Wheatstone bridge. Ooper 2 microfarad is an opposite main 2. So it is 1 ratio is inverse of other. Agar wo nahi hota, toh bhi hum kar sakte hain. But for simplify karne ke liye, we use only diagonal symmetry. ऐसे किसी भी सर्किट में सीरीज पैरेलल या कोई भी स्पेशल केस काम नहीं आएगा. सो वी हैव टू अप्लाई किरचॉफ्स लॉ ओनली. कनेक्ट अ बैटरी टेक अ चार्ज फ्रॉम बैटरी क्यू दैट डिवाइडेड Q1 Q2. इधर ऊपर 2 में Q1 था तो नीचे भी 2 में ही Q1 होगा. दैट्स बाय द डायगोनल सिमेट्री. इधर नीचे Q2 तो ऊपर Q2. देन वी अप्लाई द जंक्शन लॉ. वी हैव नाउ दीज थ्री लूप्स. इन लूप की इक्वेशन से वी हैव टू शो
यहां पे लूप्स कौन-कौन से.
हां बेटा लूप एक ये बाहर वाला बड़ा सा दिस वन.
यस सर.
एंड द अनदर इज दिस वन. द थर्ड लूप इज एग्जैक्टली सेम एज सेकंड लूप. इसकी इक्वेशन लिखने की जरूरत नहीं है.
ओके
सर. वी फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ Q1 एंड Q2.
यस सर.
Calculate Q1 plus Q2 and then Q1 plus Q2 is equal to Q1 plus Q2 is equal to 17/7. We yahan se Q by V nikalenge. So equivalent capacitance of this Wheatstone which is not balanced is 17/7. Right? Understood how to calculate equivalent capacitance using Kirchhoff's law? Yes, Bharat? Understood this?
Yes, just a minute.
Sir, लिख तो लिया, समझ आया कि नहीं?
I need to take, समझ आ गया, but I just need to take this down.
Okay, so I think Kirchhoff law, you circuit, 3D circuit mein ek do cases aur ho sakte hai, like a pyramid of circuit. Almost all the cases we did. Next is dielectric combination. And that we will do in the next class. For tomorrow, we can send you doubts. Tomorrow we'll have the doubt class. And AP sir's class is also there. And sir has started the current electricity, so don't miss. Even if you miss, then go and check the recording because I will be now teaching that part. Little faster, assuming that the basic concept, at least the understanding of basic level is there so that we can give more focus on the numerical. I will also explain all the concepts, don't worry. But it should be advantage that sir is starting from the basic first and then we'll be taking little higher level. Like all these things, Wheatstone, unbalanced Wheatstone bridge, it's not in the board level, it is in the computer level only. Right? Okay, this Kirchhoff law circuit solving using Kirchhoff law is not again in the NCRT, in the capacitor circuit. It is in the resistor circuit, current electricity charge. Right. Okay, that's it for today. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.